The views and opinions expressed in the following program are those of the hosts and guests, and not necessarily those of the staff or management of Worldwide Digital Broadcasting Corporation.
Hey!
CincinnatiBounty.com.
Back on the air. It's Tuesday, 8 p.m. We're live streaming over on our Ustream or on our website, which is CincinnatiBounty.com. We happen to be live streaming over here on Facebook via my iPad. We're trying it out, seeing if it'll work.
Toxie's got her RBF going on right now.
Yes, she does. There's been a lot of shit going on this week for everybody.
It's a shitty week.
Shitty, shitty week.
Shitty, shitty, bang, bang. We have
Vendetta who's getting static for the audio, but Cali Guys has no audio at all.
So there's a lot of stuff happening in the news right now. Football started this week. So we've got Kaepernick. I think that's how you say his name.
Kaepernick.
Kaepernick? I don't know. That sounds like Kaepernick. What'd you say?
Copernicus.
Kaepernick sounds like a satellite. Space satellite.
No, that's Sputnik.
There was a story that I saw, and I didn't. It wasn't until I read the story that I discovered it was a Canadian judge. There was a judge who told a woman, "Could you just keep your knees closed?"
Yeah, fuck that bitch. Fuck him. Fuck him right in the butthole. No lube with a pineapple.
She was a rape victim, and he said, "Couldn't you?" She was raped on a bathroom sink, and he said things like, "Could you just have scooted your butt into the sink?" And why couldn't you keep your knees closed? He is on, where he's being judged by all the other judges, whether he should remain a judge?
Why is there a question about this?
Right.
No, someone should have just walked in and should have Donald Trumped his ass, "You're fired," you know, just gotten rid of him. "You're fired."
And then I remember when Canada had that mayor that was doing crack and all that kind of stuff? So I have to remember that as much as I love Canada and as much as Canada is nice, they've got their assholes too.
I've got a story about Canada from this week. I had to call a Canadian bank because we are an international company, do international business. We have banks all over the world where we do business in the countries we do business in because it's just easier. Except that while Canadians might be nice, they don't like to talk to people on the phone. So they give you an automated system. And you have to have an account. You can't just call this bank and ask a question. You have to have an account. Thankfully, we have an account. So I call and I put in all the information about the account. Wasn't the account I was calling about, but they didn't care. But they still couldn't get me to a live person. And when I did finally get to a live person, they're like, "Okay, well, this isn't the right department. You need to talk to this person." And I was like, "Okay, can I get that department's phone number so that if we get disconnected, I can call them back?" And she said, "Sure." And she gave me the exact same phone number I had just called. And then that lady said, "Well, this is not the right department either. You need to talk to this department." So I got transferred again. And I said, "Can I get the phone number for that department in case we get disconnected?" And she said, "No." And I shit you not, there are no lines in to that department. How the fuck are you transferring me? But anyway, whatever. I eventually talked to the right person and got the information. It took over an hour on one phone call, and I spent less than 5 minutes on the phone with a live human being. That's all three of them combined, less than 5 minutes.
You know,
minutes.
I would prefer not to talk to someone live. Unless it's like an emergency, like I can't pay my bill. Or something. I would rather I pay all my bills online, so I don't have to talk to a real person. Well, and when I have to pay Cox, it's a telephone only kind of thing, and it's all automated. I love it. I don't have to talk to a person at all.
Well, so here's what happened. One of our Chinese branches got a collections letter from a collections company claiming to be claiming a collection from the Canadian bank that we bank with in Canada. Except that when you Google this collections agency, it comes up as this big scam company, right? So all I'm doing is calling the bank and saying, "Is this viable collection, do we need to go through this person or can we go through the bank? That was all. You can't do that automated. There's no way to automate that. But there is at no point ever was there an option for me to, there was an option for me to speak to a live representative that sent me into an automated system. That sent me into another automated system that finally just said, enter this and this number or stay on hold to speak to a representative. So I just stopped putting numbers in or nothing. Finally, I spoke to somebody.
My daughter was watching a commercial, an infomercial, and it was one for a bathtub that you sit in, and you sit instead of down on the ground.
Right.
Like you sit up like this, like it's a chair, and then it fills with water, and it's like a sit-up bathtub.
Yeah.
That's it. It's a walk-in
tub.
They
sell them for handicapped or the elderly.
Right. Yeah. But she wanted to know how much it was for my mother. And so
for
she,
her mother, meaning you.
For her grandmother.
Okay.
I'm sorry, for my mother. And so she logged in to chat. And so she started, you know, saying, like, I want to get some pricing. And they said, I need your number and your email address. And she's like, no, I just like some pricing. And they said, well, we need this information. And finally she's like, why would I have gone with a live chat if I actually want someone to call me?
That's pretty much true.
So
those live chats aren't manned by anyone live either. It's an AI that's specifically designed to respond.
Right.
It's not people. I'm going to bust all your burbles. Your live chat, not really live.
I like live chat features too.
I do too.
Whenever I talk to my website host, I always do the chat option.
Well, website hosts generally have to be live, actual people. But your bank or those shady mattress companies that have popped up that are selling mattresses in boxes with their live chat.
Mattress stores have live chat.
Yes.
Wow.
Online retailers of mattresses have live
chat. We could have live chat on our website if we wanted.
We do have live chat on our website.
No. I mean, just for the website. But it would go to your phone or my phone or her phone.
No.
Yeah, that's not happening.
Nope. I already got enough problems with you assholes messaging me on Facebook.
Yeah, that shit comes through our phone and we're chatting via phone to you. Nope, not gonna happen.
And I'm like, oh, look, I got another penis. Another. It looks exactly like the last five penises I got.
Let's talk about chatting.
Were you just telling us a story about Facebook Messenger?
Oh, I was, about how people keep calling me now. If I normally don't leave it logged into my show page, but sometimes I forget. And this past week, I've been woke up in the middle of the night multiple times. Like, there's some asshole out there somewhere that loves to call at 3 a.m. So just don't. It took me a while to figure out how to turn it off. I have to turn it off. I had to do it on a desktop. Versus on
right.
your phone, you can't turn it off. So
yeah, that feature on Facebook where you can call from your phone gets me into so much trouble because I'm literally butt dialing people on
right.
Facebook all the time.
Right.
You don't ever butt dial me.
That's true. But we chat text-wise instead of on Facebook mostly.
True that.
So.
No, what I love is when we send a text message to the group of the three of us, and then someone responds from one of our Facebooks that has all of our show names on it, and then the other one responds from the other Facebook group message we have that's our regular Facebook. Those are the best conversations to try to keep track of, because then you open up one of the messengers, and it's just like, and then there was mayonnaise everywhere, and it's like, I got to follow some convoluted bullshit to find out what the hell happened in this conversation.
Let's talk about, Toxie was bored while at an event and decided to...
I'm on a dating site.
One?
And, yeah, just one. I know, I was on a couple.
You need to diversify.
I was on a couple and I pulled my profile off.
J-date.
There was one that we saw in that group today. I don't know if you saw it. It's called Special Arrangements, where it's specifically people looking for a sugar daddy.
There's sugardaddy.com,
and I'm like,
too.
I didn't know there was... Like, I thought people just kind of joke. I know there are sugar daddies, but I didn't actually know there's somewhere you go.
Yeah.
There's
that one.
Them.
There's sugardaddy.com. There's Find Me a Sugar Daddy.
That's crazy.
There's a ton of them.
So I'm on all of them now.
She's secretly writing it down over there.
Sugardaddy.com.
Sugardaddy.com. And I saw from looking that there's a sugar daddy and a sugar baby. So
you'd be the
What's
baby.
What's a sugar baby?
The person who has a sugar daddy. Oh. The one that's not the sugar
gotcha.
Daddy.
What about the sugar mama?
That's cougars.com. That's cougars.com.
No, you can be a cougar and be poor.
Any cougar I ran into would be 300 years old.
I know when I hit 40, I'm like, official cougar status. So.
Tomorrow, right?
Yes, that's it.
But that means you'll have to date someone who's 20 to make you an official cougar.
Shoot, I didn't know that was the criteria. Okay, all right, never mind.
You see how disappointed she is in that. Oh, darn, I didn't know.
Gosh, if
so
I
let's
have
talk
to...
about this so... text, these text okay. messages.
So I normally don't reply to some. And a lot, actually. And especially if they're like a little bit, if they're vulgar or just whatever. I
just so you know,
start off with a penis.
And it's just not toxy, but all of us get vulgar messages.
If your icebreaker is, are you DTF, then we usually just ignore that.
What's DTF?
Well, this, down to fuck.
Yeah, oh. Down to fuck. This icebreaker was, you ever been fisted?
That was the very first message they sent.
The very first message. The very first message. So, of course, I'm sitting there. I'm bored at soccer. I'm probably the only soccer mom having this conversation. I guarantee you, like, I sat there thinking, if these other moms know what I'm typing right this moment, like, I would be shunned. I would not be allowed on a field.
Wait, aren't these the soccer moms you used to get drunk with?
No, we're on a new team now.
Oh,
and they don't true. Drink.
Oh, no.
And so it's awful.
You know, all these really good stories I get out of you all start the same. I was at soccer. I got this text message.
They do. They all start. I was at soccer. So he said, you ever been fisted? I said, hasn't everyone? Right? And his response was, can I do you? And so my response was, absolutely. But I only do it as a mutual fisting, and we have to do it at the same time. That's the hottest way. So, no response. I don't know why. I got no response, and I waited for a while, and I waited. And finally I said, I'm excited to get this going. Can we set up a date? I have industrial strength gloves, and I'm almost embarrassed to admit, the 55-gallon drum of lube from Amazon.
Which is available, by the way. Thank you, Amazon.
Thank you.
So he just sent a quick response, LMAO, and I said, listen, I'll be gentle the first time, I promise. And he said, I wasn't expecting that. You good, LOL. And I said, I am good. No complaints yet. It's because I invested in that drum. There's no shortage of lube. And that was it. He didn't respond.
Never
I
responded.
I don't understand.
That is the best way to troll a troll. I think you have perfected trolling trolls on those shitty fucking dating sites.
At least he didn't start yelling at you about how much you're a fat bitch.
Right.
And,
right.
Why would you even bring something like that up? And I was just trying to be nice, to do you a favor. Fuck you.
It happens sometimes.
Bitch, I can walk into any bar looking like anything I want and walk out with a piece of dick as long as I ain't too picky. Can't be picky with the dicky.
I love that story, though.
Yeah. So, I'm still waiting for a response. I was hoping, like, we could
Are
go
you gonna,
on
like, in a couple
show.
Days, message him and go, are we gonna hook up or
I'm
what?
I'm gonna send a picture of the industrial strength gloves.
And send DTF down
yeah.
to your fist.
DTF. Yes. Exactly.
Dentifest.
So.
Sit in the hallway with headphones on.
Are you too young for this show?
Is this too much for you?
Nothing I like better than making people run screaming into the night.
Oh, Vendetta said no on special arrangements. They have sugar mamas. And Toxie Wins. I think so. Look for sugarmamas.com. And then Toxie Wins BAMF of the week.
Badass motherfucker.
I am.
I'm going to send you a picture from up for back here that says BAMF right above Toxie.
No. We should totally do a twist on the BASF thing. Was like making things better or whatever it is. So it's BAMF, making dating better. Toxie.
So I was combing news stories. I found like a ton of news stories. I posted them all to our Facebook page and Twitter. and our Google Plus. But one of the stories I found that in Italy, masturbation is now legal in public, unless there are children around.
Oh, well, yeah, okay, then I'm down with that. I mean, listen.
Why? Well, it's like the public urinating and all that stuff. For some reason, I guess they had a lot of court cases and over there in Italy about guys pulling out their penises. And it's only usually women that complain. And they said, well, women can just look away.
It's true. They can. Oh, that side offends me. Look somewhere else.
Yeah.
Like, so here's the thing. I get penises are not that much fun to look at. Most of the time, they're just wrinkly and sad and kind of squirmy looking. And when a guy's
they're
peeing...
They're both back there like, do we say something? Do we...
They know. They know. Well.
You don't look so sad.
We almost had a good show. And when they're peeing, they're not at their best. So anyway.
In the morning.
And then you gotta like do headstands and push stuff down. I know I'm dealing with that with my preteen.
And what is it with you guys and dicks and
what? I don't have any problems with it. It's just pee. Everybody pees. Girls pee, boys pee, dogs pee, cats pee, everybody pee.
Listen,
you know,
for the record.
The first question out of a woman's mouth is, can I hold that when you do it?
I have never asked a guy to hold his dick while he pees in my
life.
Now we all the really weird ones.
No, you
now,
can't.
We all know what kind of bars Ginger goes to now.
Now, not all penises are ugly, though.
No,
there
I
are
didn't
some
say
beautiful
all.
Penises.
I said most. Most of the time, they're.
But
just...
she is right. When they're like at half mast and they're like they're kind of sticking out and then they droop down, they look really sad.
They do. And then they're, you know, they're just kind of dribbling from the mouth. It's not anything anyone wants to look at. When you see it, what's the first thing you do? Oh, I didn't want to see
Do you
that.
Know what can be ugly and what can be beautiful is the way a guy masturbates his penis.
Fuck yeah, it is. That's my
number
one.
Sometimes that shit is sexy as hell. So if I'm ever walking the streets of Italy and some dude is masturbating, I'm going to check out his technique. And if it's any good, I'll probably pull up a chair.
And masturbate with him because now it's legal in public.
I would still be uncomfortable with that just because you never know when a child can walk by or
True.
If they're up in the window or driving by in a car.
True.
So I'm still not comfortable. However, I have no problem like guiding him to the alley so I could watch. I don't see an issue with that. Like,
no. If you're in a bar where no kids are allowed anyway?
Okay, all right.
And a guy's just like, man, well, girl, you are hot.
We've had it.
From what I understand, the problem is so prevalent over there that it was clogging up the jail system. So they decided to decriminalize masturbation in public so that it wouldn't clog up the intake to the jail system.
The penal system.
Say it. We cleaned up the penal system by making penises okay. I'm okay with this. Putting people in jail for masturbating is a terrible crime, especially when they're masturbating in public, as long as there are no children involved, is literally a victimless crime, which means it shouldn't be a crime.
But where can they be in public other than inside a building?
How
like
about in the
doctor's office, like in the proctologist's office?
Italy is filled with piazzas, which is huge town square, sometimes with a fountain in the middle. They are everywhere in Italy.
Outside Vatican City?
But I'm saying there's not many places that children cannot see.
Yes, there are plenty of places that a person can go that are considered public, where if they pulled their penis out with American legislation, it would be considered public indecency, such as in a porno theater where pornos are playing and children are not allowed.
That's
do you know how many
right.
people go to jail for masturbating in a porno
theater?
Okay,
I mean that...
Maybe Herman.
Right, I get that. I get that. You go in there, you expect it to be sticky, you know not to sit in front of anyone. I get that. But I don't know.
So now in Italy,
that means anybody, just because you don't see a child and you're walking down the street, that doesn't mean they can't be looking out the window, driving by in a car.
There will be a huge fine assessed and maybe some jail time if there is a child present.
It's easy to do. You can masturbate in public now, so you go to places where masturbation is acceptable in a public place, such as a bar where there aren't going to be any children, or a masturbation place like a porno theater, or
like a cigar club.
A cigar slash masturbation club.
And then I would think business policy. Business policy would override as well, because you know,
I'm sure there'll be, you know, no shirt, no shoes, penis in your pants, no service kind of thing.
It's like Nevada's open carry law. We have an open carry law. And you can walk into almost any place with a gun on your hip. But there are some places that have a sign up that says no open carry, courthouses, etc., some businesses. So schools, I think.
Yeah, you can't be on school grounds, and you can't be on any, even if it's private property that caters to a club specifically for children, like Boys and Girls Clubs.
Right.
But there's stores that specifically do, because I remember Costco, there was that issue where that gentleman was shot because he was carrying the gun, and they came and said, you can't have it in here. And he argued that he was acting erratic, and he got shot on the way out by the police.
Right.
But
Don't act erratic. Here's my thing for handgun owners. If you are in possession of a legally purchased, legally licensed handgun that is yours, don't act like a fucking asshole. You're going to get shot. You look like an asshole when you act like an asshole, and cops don't like assholes. They'll shoot you. So if anyone says, I see your gun, you're not supposed to have it, here you go. My bad. I'm sorry. You turn around, you leave. That's it. It's not that fucking hard. They didn't ask you to give them your gun. They didn't say you can't have that gun ever anywhere. They just said, we don't allow your gun in here. So you go, ah, my bad. Sorry. So you go back to your car, you put it in the trunk, you go back into the building.
That's it.
Not that hard. Don't be an asshole. Seriously, like 97.2% of all the problems in the world would be solved if everybody would just go, I'm not going to be an asshole today. Like,
That's a true statistic, by the way. 97.2.
You can Google that shit. It's on Wiki something or other, I'm sure.
Isn't it 97.1?
Speaking of assholes, so everybody has lost their shit today because Brock Turner wants to lecture.
Oh.
I lost my shit. I think if there was ever an instance where I might advocate for somebody just shooting a fucker in the head.
And this all stems from an opinion piece written on HuffPo about, well, he mentioned it casually, I guess, about lecturing about rape, drinking, and promiscuity. About drinking and promiscuity. Not about don't rape women.
Right. Not like just because she's drunk and passed out, you should rape her. Like that, no. No, well, he's so, like, don't be drunk and a hoe.
He wants to, so he's considering. He has not launched a series of appearances yet because nobody has made appointments for him to come to their college or anything.
Nobody's going to make appointments for him to come to their college.
But it's not about being young white boy and how doing something so heinous could ruin your career. It's about how women are and being drinking and being promiscuous.
I've been really stabby this week, and this makes me super stabby.
But everybody just lost their minds. But just so you know, he has not set any dates yet. He's talked about it. He's talked seriously about it lately.
Somewhere there's a student union just laughing.
There's going to be, there will be so many protesters at any, if any college.
I find it dangerous for him because what it would do is if he was on the lecture circuit, it would have specific dates and locations where he would be appearing. How asinine.
He'd have to show up in the Pope Mobile.
How stupid could he be? And I might be in agreement if he's going around and his lecture was on, like, hey, don't be an asshole and rape people. Like, then I probably could say, like, okay, you're using this for good. You see the light.
You know, if he had a 2-hour lecture and his first hour was fucking apologizing. And that's, be all right with that.
That's exactly what the HuffPo piece was about. It was before he's even allowed to lecture, he really needs to issue a true apology for what he did to
but
this
he
woman.
Wants to lecture on that binge drinking in college, like on the dangers of that. So again, he is basically blaming the victim once again for his actions.
Or blaming the alcohol. Even if he turns it around and says, I was drinking really heavily and I like to fuck everything, being promiscuous.
Then don't drink.
That's the danger. He's not blaming himself still. He's still blaming something else.
If drinking makes you rape people, then you need to stop drinking. If anything you do makes you hurt other people, you need to stop doing that thing.
Or get help for it.
Yeah. Get help for it and stop doing it. Get help and stop doing it.
Yeah.
If owning a gun means you shoot people, don't own a gun. If you're just going to randomly shoot people, you shouldn't own a gun.
But you have to think, though, if you have a tendency to want to shoot people or want to rape people, do you really think you're going to be sound mind enough to go and seek out the help that you need?
No, you're not. So when you get caught raping a girl and two men have to hold you down to keep you from raping a girl, when you get punished for that, it should be something a lot more than 3 months in prison with, like, what, 18 months of probation, maybe? He'll probably get off for good behavior.
I read something today because I was having a very interesting discussion with somebody on Facebook in regards to this. But it was, his sentence is suggested at 14 years, specific for that state and that crime. The prosecution recommended a very modest 6 years.
I would have
just
been okay
an
with
idea of, like, how far off we are.
I think this would have never even come to, it wouldn't have never been national news if he'd gotten the 6 years.
Right.
If he'd gotten 6 years, then everyone would have just been like, rapist got jail time. He'll get buffucked while he's in there. Because you know that bitch was in solitary the whole 3 months he was there.
Right.
He never got the chance to go into Gen Pop and get his ass butt fucked, which is what should have happened. Somebody should have held him down and raped him.
That's not what should have happened.
No.
Rape in any venue whatsoever, male on male, women raping men. No, rape is not good.
If I were a Christian, I'd be an eye for an eye Christian.
But it doesn't, because then it's basically saying that you advocate rape is okay in some circumstances, not in others.
Right. Where do you draw the line?
He
right.
should, that the justice system should have taken care of things.
Yeah.
Not you know, some dude sneaking up from behind calling him Bubba, but it should have.
It's not Bubba, it's Baby.
Whatever it is.
Brock Turner would have been the bitch.
That's just saying it's okay.
So, yeah, the protesters thing, all the women on any campus is just going to come out.
Right.
And
No, not all the women. There will be that one psycho Donald Trump bitch who will show up and be like, well, she shouldn't have been dressed like that, shouldn't have been
marrying me. I'll marry you, Brock. Whatever.
You're so cute.
Ugh. So, speaking of protesters, let's go on to the Locke story.
Lochte.
And I know that...
Lochte the liar.
Toxie wanted to talk about this more than anything.
Well, I love Dancing with the Stars. I love it. And I don't have live TV anymore, so I had to watch it today. And I was so excited because it's back on. And... it gets to it. Did you guys see it?
Or no.
Did you see
the I watched the videos.
A clip, but okay. I didn't see the whole thing.
So what the audience saw was they cut away. So Ryan Lochte gave a dance. Like, he danced, and he danced with Cheryl Burke, who is a fan favorite who's been away for a few years. So she came back. She's partnered with him. And from the get-go, everybody said, Dancing with the Stars is all about second chances. They've had a lot of stars on there who have had really bad pasts, who have done bad things, who have
really
made mistakes,
things.
Really bad, who have made mistakes, and this was their second chance. Let me just tell you that the time that Bristol Palin was on, I thought people got nasty with her. It was nothing like this. It was nothing. So the dance is over, and all you see is that they're giving him feedback, and it cuts away, and the one judge is going, no, get away. And then you see security come by. So I watched the somebody from their camera phone, and basically these guys came down, and one came, like, not like he was going to beat him, but he, like, started to come at him, and security, like, came and took him down.
Right.
And they had ripped off their shirts, because you have to be dressed a certain way to be there. And they had, like, Lock D and a no sign on their chest. And so, anyway, they got them out of there, and he was visibly shaken up. But then there were still girls in the audience, about four or five,
right,
who had ripped off their shirts, and they had tank tops on that said the same. And one of the dancers had to come out, and he's like, no, you're out of here. This is a positive, uplifting experience. And this poor guy's just standing there. He just danced in front of millions of people. He's obviously been through a lot. And I get it, people. He lied. What this boy did was he told his mama a lie.
And his mama got mad and told everybody else.
Shared, and it blew up from there. And at first he didn't know what to do, so he continued with the lie. But that doesn't mean he should be dead. Like, that doesn't mean he should be...
That's true.
Like, just tore up so bad. We have people who have done much worse. Like, this dude lied to his mama. That's what he did when it comes down to it. He did not boil puppies. He did not go over there and, like, murder people. He did not steal... Right? He did not steal other people's, you know, medals and put... You know, super glue in their shampoo. He did none of that. He
put Nair in their shampoo, not super glue.
Super glue. Sticks your hand.
And it doesn't work that way.
Yeah, but.
Well, it did in a movie once.
Okay.
It doesn't work that fast, but Nair does work that fast.
So he didn't do any of that. He didn't. He disgraced the U.S., but we have Trump running. Like, we're doing it ourselves.
Yeah. No, Lochte was not where we went wrong.
Like, he's not the, you know, he's not like the epitome of awfulness in the U.S. We have Trump.
You know, I was thinking about this too, and it wasn't the fact that I think he was on Dancing with the Stars too soon. Number one.
Yeah.
You know, if maybe a year from now it would have been fine, but this just happened.
That's normally when they do it. Actually, just so you know, from the history of the show, they love to grab people as they're hot for a ratings purpose.
Yeah.
And their PR says, but it works in many, many cases.
I just think they should have waited. But I was thinking about, it's not so, because he got a standing ovation after the security was taken care of and everything.
Right.
And I'm thinking they gave him a fucking standing ovation. But it's that concept. Like, I can think he's an asshole, but you better not call him an asshole because I will fucking kick your ass. Right. So it's like, he's one of ours, motherfucker.
Well, I think it's like, here's the deal. Like, going back to Brock. Brock fucking hasn't even apologized. This guy's apologized many times. This guy has gone on national TV and apologized. And he has said, I made a mistake. In the beginning of the show, he brought it up again. I made a mistake. You know, I've learned from it. I will make sure I don't do it again. He's like, what more do you want him to do? Do you want him to give you blood? No. Like, it is the right time for him to be on there. I just don't think anybody expected so much hate.
There shouldn't be. The level of hate between the two, it's disproportionate. So, like, maybe, yeah, a couple of catcalls or somebody hollering from the top of the bleachers, look, he's a lawyer, you know, that frat boy bullshit. Like, that would have been perfectly acceptable. But the charge on the stage, all he did was lie to his mama to get some sympathy and maybe a couple of extra bucks for some more ramen. Like, I don't...
Mom!
They didn't charge him. They walked out on the stage, two men, took their shirts off, and said, he's a liar.
But the one, if you watch...
Everybody else freaked out, though.
If you watch the unedited, he didn't touch him. He didn't get at him. He came very close, but he went at him, and security came and took him down.
Yeah.
So he didn't touch him.
No.
But if security hadn't stopped, that's where it was going. Like, he was going towards him. But he didn't need to be down there. He didn't need to be on the floor at all.
They could have been standing up in the stands saying, Lochte's a liar.
And that's their right. They could have ripped off their shirts and stood up there and screamed like, you're a liar, you're a whatever. And that's great. But you know what? Now they're being charged with trespassing. And I believe there was something on TMZ where they were saying, like, oh, they hurt us. The security hurt us. They went overboard. So
that's probably all they did it for, was to try to get beat up by security so they could sue them.
Well, one said One gentleman said that he had been in, God, where was it going to be?
Brazil.
Brazil. He had been there, and that what Ryan did caused him to be, caused him discomfort or something. It caused him something while he was there.
It pissed me off, too, and I'm an American.
Right, it pissed off many people, but even beyond the fact that he lied, a bunch of guys, he just won a shit ton of medals. He's been training for this for a million years on a very rigid schedule. He won a shit ton of medals. And so he went out and he celebrated and he did something stupid while he was drunk. And
how many of us can say we've never done something stupid while we're drunk?
I haven't. Never. So anyway,
there's a reason she don't drink tequila no more.
Were we just talking about Brock Turner doing something stupid when he was drunk?
Yes.
Right.
But level he didn't of stupidity rape somebody. Here. Yeah. Lochte didn't rape somebody.
They hit some signs coming out of the bathroom.
Yeah, but stupidity, being stupid while drunk is not an excuse.
No.
Right. It's not. However, again, I'm just saying where all this snowballed from. What
people
it should have been.
Glass houses should not throw fucking stones. Like he without the. I'm like Christian today. Like
you right? are.
Wow, I converted right? when
should
I walked in the door. It's like
we hold hands and pray. What's
I'm
going
to talk in tongues next. Like going back to my roots.
Well, I think Lochte should hire you as his PR consultant.
Because she'd just be like, guys, he's super nice. He did something stupid.
No, I've always thought he was a douche. I'm not saying.
Oh yeah, no.
I mean, I've heard he's
king of the douches.
I've heard, you know, he's kind of nice, but he's a douche. That doesn't change anything. Like when he comes out and he, you know, before and he'd be talking all douchey. It doesn't change anything.
It's because they ruined her show, is what it is.
No, it has nothing to do with the show. Even that man has apologized. How many of our Olympics? How many? Forget Olympics. How many of our professional athletes have beat their wives?
Oh.
And they still play?
Or how about the guys that
cheered,
have killed people?
Are cheered
yeah.
by how many in the stadium? And people wear their jerseys and they beat their fucking wives.
There is a lot of disproportionate anger and vitriol aimed at people who should not have it and not aimed at people who should.
Oh, here's an example just to share, and I'm so sorry I missed some chat. But Vendetta said, like with Paula Deen, it helped her a bit. Paula Deen went on immediately after, while all
onto
of that was
Dancing
going
with
on,
the Stars.
Onto Dancing with the Stars.
I didn't
stars.
Even know that.
Me
and
either.
They, absolutely, and you're right, Vendetta. Thank you. It humanizes that.
Did they get Did they get the playmate model? That sent out that
Danny
Mathers.
No.
They should get her on that show.
It already started. I mean, this is. You know, they kind of got. Now they got to. They like to get people straight out of the Olympics.
I think I just found a whole new reason to not like Dancing with the Stars.
They have him and one of the gymnasts, so they always try and get some straight off the Olympics.
I think having a gymnast on Dancing with the Stars is cheating, y'all, because they do have to do a dance routine.
Oh, and Kelly Guy said he'll be ready for the next Korea Olympics, where boiling puppies is an official new event.
They call that dinner.
Oh, so as an Asian, I should probably call that racist.
Yes. Except most Asians are like super racist against other Asians.
Yeah, true.
It's crazy.
And all of the races.
And all of the races.
But yeah.
I heard the greatest joke ever this week.
No, don't.
I can't tell this joke.
Tox is here.
I'm already like... Let's not do it.
Okay.
Don't do it.
So I was watching a Jeff Foxworthy.
Don't do it.
And Larry the Cable Guy comedy special.
Oh, definitely don't do it.
And Larry Cable Guy says he's got this little short friend. He's called him a little person. He says, I have this little person friend. And he likes to take selfies with his selfie stick. He runs around, take pictures of myself. Like, he takes pictures of himself. And he goes, if a little person takes a selfie, is it called an elfie?
By the way, there is a little person on Dancing with the Stars. The one from LA, Little Women of LA, the one who just had the baby.
Yeah.
She did amazing.
Is there a reality show called Little Women of LA?
Yes.
Yeah, and it's all about, it's Real Housewives of LA with little people who get drunk.
Mm-hmm. My mom would love that show.
You should turn around to it. It's fabulous.
My mom would love that show. I have to tell her about it.
You're going to have to send us, you're gonna have to watch her watch it with her so you can send us her comments.
Oh yeah,
because that you could start an entire podcast about that.
She
no, my
she,
mom's reaction.
She already loves the little person show that's on what TLC right now or
there's
whatever
like,
it is.
The one with the family.
Yes,
they there are two. There's the one with the sons.
This is the husband and wife with the kids.
They're doctors.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's that one, and then there's the one where they have, they're married and they have children, and one of the children is normal size.
No, a couple of their children.
One of the twins. One of the twins is. That's right.
Right. Yeah, I don't know if she watches that one, but I know she watches the one with the husband and wife.
That
she
had to adopt
loves,
the
babies. Yeah, yeah. She loves that show.
It's a good show. I like that show too. I don't DVR it, but I like it. I'll watch it when it's on.
What else do we want to talk about?
Healthy. I had to pause it and laugh. It was so funny, because the thing that made it the funniest was not the joke itself.
Yeah.
But the reaction I knew I would get out of Toxie when I told her that joke.
And Kelly Guy said, yes, call it racist right after you stop laughing, LOL. I'm more so laughing at her.
It was the greatest thing.
Versus.
When I hear those jokes, I laugh, not, well, because they're funny, but I also laugh because I know what her reaction is going to be to them as soon as I tell them to her.
She, do you know, not that long ago, it was just the other day, you fucking tagged me in one.
I did.
And all I said was no. No. Just no. That is all I could say. No.
I'm sure it was terrible.
No. It was horrible.
Keep it into that secret group that we have.
That's where it was.
Yeah, yeah.
Someone posted something in there, and then she tags me.
Was it the one
where... I don't even post it.
Wasn't it one where it was an Asian joke?
Right, it was.
And she was asking, is it racist?
Right.
And I loved reading the comments on all of that. So I love having a venue like that where we can discuss things.
Oh, that was the one about when Asians
don't make... Say it, don't say it out loud.
Fun of white people.
So anyway, it got very heated.
I think in the end,
a lot of people who didn't realize before, they're like, oh, this may not have been appropriate. Okay. So I do get that out of there sometimes, where there may be something that even I haven't thought of before, and I'm like, oh, I didn't see it that way. Whether I agree or disagree, like, I didn't see that perspective. And so it helps.
Yeah, and one of the things that I got out of it was just because your Asian friend laughed at it doesn't mean it's not racist.
Right, right. So, the one girl said, I have one Asian friend who thought it wasn't racist. And you're like, that doesn't make it not racist.
And that goes for every race, right? I have one black friend. He's the one that gave me the joke. Doesn't make it not racist.
Yeah.
I got all kinds of redneck wife beating jokes. I don't get offended by them, but they are pretty racist too. So
yeah,
pretty stereotyping.
Yeah, and we can go into a whole new discussion about stereotype because I've been there before.
I've been stereotyped regularly.
Being fat makes you stereotyped.
Mm. Being white and female gets you serious stereotyping too, especially when you live on the East Side.
As we do.
We do.
We heard that a lot. This week, I think it was, oh, East Side, like, fuck you in your disdain of the East Side. I've lived there all my life.
At least I don't live on the, oh, no, that's racist. I can't say that.
Although, Toxie and I, Sierra couldn't go because her man wasn't feeling good, but Toxie and I went to Gina's event.
We did.
G-Spot event over at, before I say the name, so I'm in this, we're in this bar and we're visiting with all these ladies. I haven't seen them in years because I've been off the show for a couple of years, you know, and so I'm like reunited and I'm, you know, visiting and having a great time. There's great rap music going on and R&B and I'm sitting there jamming and then I hear the lyrics and it's get on your knees, bitch, and I'm like... I just stopped for a minute, you know, because the music was great, but then I listened to the lyrics, and I have to remind myself not to listen to rap lyrics.
Right.
Rap is not for the lyrics.
At one point, you brought the DJ over, and we were talking, and I looked at him straight in the face, like, no smile or anything, and I'm like, can you play some Taylor Swift?
And he looked her straight in the face and said,
He goes, I can... He said, but I mean, I'm going to have to explain why it was requested.
All so, you have to do is point to me.
So we had just taken a bunch of pictures with some of these people, and there were some great overheard comments that I had to post. So I'm doing the social media, and I'm leaning up against this half wall watching the pool table. And on the wall, there is this beautiful mural painting of a Viking ship on the sea and ghost figures of Vikings and or Nordic men on the wall. And I was like, that is so awesome. So I took a photo with it. And then as I was posting it, I realized we were at the Cracker Bar.
Spelled with a K. As in Unca. Cracker.
And I just, the irony of it, just, I'm a fat girl at a bar listening to rap and R&B, surrounded by black and Hispanic people and a few white people staring at Vikings on the wall at the Cracker Bar.
Cracker.
It was such an amalgamation. It was great.
It was a nice place. I have to tell you.
On the east side.
The restroom.
On the east side.
The restroom.
Give you syphilis?
What? No.
It's like your grandma's restroom.
Yeah. It's like someone lived there. I'm in there. I actually took a few pictures. I'm like, it's like someone lived there. Like there's, I have to find what it was called. There's magazines in there that were obviously being read. And it was called.
Was it Country Living?
No, Easy Rides, Easy Riders.
Yeah, Easy Riders.
That's a magazine. That's a motorcyclist's magazine.
Yeah,
right. This was on the ledge, and I don't know what it is, but I felt like I wanted to use it.
It's like
I
don't know what you would like use. Like a loofah, kind of.
Yeah, try not to slide those pictures to the side because it will not be pretty.
Oh, it won't show up on
you
the.
You gotta get it closer. You're too far away.
Oh, there it is.
There you go. So, I didn't know what it was, but it looked cool.
Kind of like a loofah.
Kind of like a sex toy. It's a knobby cock ring.
And so they had some Easy Rider magazines, like one being red.
Right.
And then the bathroom looked like somebody kicked it down, like the door.
So, let me explain the whole Nordic bar, cracker thing. This is probably, with the Easy Riders in the bathroom, this is normally a biker bar.
Probably.
White biker bar.
Yep.
Maybe some sheets.
But it was...
No, you said that the last time. No.
The current owner, we met with her, we met with the current owner's family. It's a family-owned bar. Ooh. And she put, the bartender put on the event in conjunction with Gina. So she knew exactly what was coming.
All right.
And had no issues with it. And I thought it was great. They're doing some kind of masquerade this
Friday.
They are
Friday. In
October. No, oh, is it October? Mm-hmm. So they're having another event. Some of the same, I think it's going to be the same DJ and some of the same musicians are going to be there. I don't know if they'll have any live music or anything like that, which would be awesome. They've got a great dance floor and...
It is going to have, actually, I saw, they're going to have some performances.
Right.
So I think some of her, Gina manages some talent.
Yes.
And so I believe some of her talent will be performing.
Right. We'll be having them on the show, too. So they're very handsome men. We took pictures.
We did.
Yeah.
I saw them.
But if you're not afraid of the East Side, I don't know why you should be. But go check it out. It's Friday nights. I think she has something there every Friday night.
I think that's ultimately what they plan to do.
Gotcha.
So go anyway. The bar was cool. The drink prices were reasonable.
Yeah.
I didn't drink, which is a rarity for me. But
oh,
from
right.
others who
Drove.
Did, yeah. From others who did, like the prices were very reasonable.
Yep.
So.
Did you drink?
No.
I'm so sad I didn't go. I was nursing a
yeah,
very
because a
kooky
sober
boyfriend.
Toxie is a fun toxie.
Yeah. No, because I could have been the drunk one. I don't do that,
that
very often.
That would have been fun.
I don't do that
I
very often.
I would have taken crazy videos with you.
Anything else we need to discuss personal-wise before? Because we've got, what, 5 minutes left? 6 minutes left?
Yeah, I want to talk about this, my bag.
Oh.
So I'm going to get a little nerdy with you for a minute. So my bestie from high school, we'll call her Jessica Rabbit, she lives in a state far, far away, and she sent me a message asking me if I still liked Star Trek, because I was a nerd then, I'm a nerd now. And I was like, yeah, and she goes, well, I get this subscription box every month, and I'm not a big Star Trek fan, I'm going to send you some stuff. And I was like, cool. So she sent me this great little bag. I know you can't really see it up there.
Oh, yeah, you can see it. It's good.
Yeah, look at that. So I'm going to show you my danglies. It's the Enterprise and Uhura and some tribbles.
Is it balls?
It's tribbles.
They're tribbles.
What's a tribble?
I'll have to go find the episode for you.
It's balls.
She barely knows who Captain Kirk is. So here you go for the Ustreamers.
William Shatner.
Yeah, and
I'm so jealous right now.
You should be.
Here's what happens
right now. I go. And then I get this cool pin. It's the Live Long and Prosper L Lap. Yay. Stay right there because I got another thing.
I'm going to do that from now on. When people do nice things for me, like open the door or lend me a dollar.
Walking Dead bracelet.
I'll be like, what the fuck are you doing?
And this is from what, Loot Crate she got this from?
Well, I wasn't going to mention it, but yeah.
Oh. There are a bunch of places out there that you sign up for a monthly thing. You a box full of stuff, but there are other places on there that check them out for you to make sure it's worth it. I love those things. I was watching Good Morning America today, and I have been, you know, those made for special on TV, the TV infomercials. Mm-hmm. I'm addicted to those.
Me too.
Right? I want to buy everything that's there. But Good Morning America has a try it, buy it segment. I think once a week or something on their show. And one of the things I've had my eye on is that straightening brush. It's a brush that gets heated,
right,
and you just brush your hair and it straightens your hair. They tried it yesterday morning, or maybe it was this morning on Good Morning America, and that shit works. Nice. So my ass is buying one of those.
Kelly Guy said The Trouble with Tribbles was one of the best episodes ever.
It was one of the best episodes ever. Tribbles replicate exponentially.
Tribbles are also, I think, in every single series. They show up in every single Star Trek series.
I think they have to. I think there's some sort of Gene Roddenberry bylaw about tribbles. I got little tribbles. I got a big tribble, too, at my house.
Do you want to... We haven't talked about this yet. Do you want to talk about Kaepernick?
Kaepernick? Well, let's talk about the...
Football started this weekend.
Yes, football started this weekend. Woo. I want to talk about the insanity of everybody talking about how disrespectful everyone else is being because they don't stand during the national anthem. One, there is no rule that says you have to stand during the national anthem.
Nope.
Two, taking a knee is more respectful than standing for the national anthem. And three, it is his United States, God's given right to do whatever the fuck he wants during the national anthem as long as he is not being disruptive. And he is not.
Just to share, the very first time he remained seated on the bench.
Yeah.
But a veteran came and talked to him and said it's still respectful if you take a knee.
Yes.
And so that's what he did. So it gets his point across, but he takes a knee for that reason.
So over the weekend, at a lot of different games, there were other players in solidarity with Kaepernick who did the same. Either they took a knee or some of them raised their fists. They stood, but they raised their fists, and
perfectly acceptable.
I think there were 5 players on the Dolphins team that did it, and the Dolphins, mm-hmm, the club itself, put out a statement saying, "Hey, they're Americans; they can do whatever it is that they want to do."
The only people required to stand for the national anthem are active duty service members. Even inactive duty service members don't have to stand. Retired. Veteran, you don't have to stand for the national anthem, but they do out of respect. That doesn't mean everyone else has to. They can show the respect in some other way. If I can't stand, and I'm very close coming to the point where standing up and sitting down, rah, 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 is way too much for my knees, I may have to sit through the national anthem. Is someone going to berate me? Am I going to have to get it tattooed across my forehead? I served in the armed forces. I can sit if I want to. Like, is that...
And the thing is that the couch quarterbacks who are arguing this from home probably aren't standing in their living rooms,
right,
during the national anthem.
Let me tell you, when I was growing up and in school, I'm a military brat. So I went to school on military bases, where they teach you protocol. You do not have to stand for the national anthem, although they ask that you do. You are not required to put your hand over your heart, as so many people do.
That's only for the Pledge of Allegiance.
You're not required to sing along with the national anthem.
You're not required. You should probably take off your hat, but it's not a requirement.
That's just etiquette. See, the thing about the national anthem is the only thing they ask you to do is be respectful and stay quiet during the national anthem. That's what we ask everyone to do at the Olympics when the national anthems for other countries are being played.
I was just going to mention that's exactly right.
The thing is that the people who have issues with this, the reason behind it makes them uncomfortable.
Yeah.
So instead of saying this is real and this makes me uncomfortable and here's why, it's much easier to, you know, want to
punch. He's being a disrespectful jerk. No, he isn't. You
some
are.
People in the face for.
You are infringing on his First Amendment right to express himself freely.
Yep.
Fuck you, you fucking fuck.
So one of the last things I wanted to talk about is I found a story. I'm a science nerd, of course. Not nerd, because I'm not a scientist. I love all things science.
15 seconds.
Really? No, we were like 2 minutes before. Are we out of time?
Yeah, look at the clock.
Oh. Forget
save
it.
Save it for next science. Week.
Inoculate your kids.
You check your head for every one of them.
This is Alexia.
This is Sierra.
Toxie.
We'll be back next Tuesday.
If you're brave enough.
Later, bitches!